Why is seafood healthy? Well, it turns out that many kinds of seafood have healthy marine omega-3 fatty acids. These are healthy fats that are found in fish and other types of seafood, as I'm about to show you.
All right, then. Let's go fishing.
Today, we'll learn from Dr. William Lee, a renowned expert in the field of nutrition and health. Dr. Lee is a physician, author, and researcher who has dedicated his career to understanding the connection between diet and health. He's particularly known for his groundbreaking work on stem cells and the role of food in activating and supporting these vital cells. In this video, we'll dive deep into the world of seafood and its incredible benefits for our health. Dr. Lee will share his insights on how specific types of seafood can nourish our bodies, promote stem cell activity, and contribute to overall well-being. Let's listen to the doctor tell us why omega-3s are so important for stem cells and our overall health.
Welcome back to the Longevity Deprocess channel.
But let's go ahead and take a look at omega-3s, which are the beneficial healthy fats of PUFAs, polyunsaturated fatty acids, that we tend not to get enough of. So, you know, omega-3s are a family of fatty acids. They're sort of EPA or eicosapentaenoic acid, EPA, or DHA, which is docosahexaenoic acid. And these actually originally come from algae and plankton and sort of plants of the sea, as I like to call them. And, you know, little critters, little fish, little shellfish eat the algae and the plankton. They build up the omega-3s in their bodies, which then are eaten by larger fish. And then you go up the food chain, the smaller fish are eaten by the next larger fish, and so on and so forth.
Go fish.
So, what can omega-3s do for us?
Oh, a quick favor. We'd greatly appreciate it if you can subscribe and like. This helps the YouTube algorithm recognize the value of our content and share it more widely.
Omega-3s are Mother Nature's natural anti-inflammatory substances. They trigger your body to burn harmful extra body fat. Now, body fat has a lot of inflammation. So when you burn down fat, you're also lowering the amount of inflammation that the fat itself causes. So omega-3s can help to extinguish some of that fat. Omega-3 fatty acids that you might get from Mediterranean sea bass or cod, like we talked about, turns on brown fat. So let me tell you about brown fat. Brown fat is a special type of healthy fat in our bodies, and it's not wiggly jiggly, like the stuff that you don't want on your butt or your thighs or under your arms or under your chin. That's called white fat. Brown fat isn't wiggly jiggly. Brown fat is wafer thin, and it's not located like in the muffin top. Brown fat is pasted around the sides of your neck, under your breastbone, between your shoulder blades, and a little bit inside, deep inside your belly. And what it does is it actually, it fires up to burn down fat. So it's like a space heater, all right? And when a space heater turns on, it needs fuel to burn things down. And guess what? Omega-3s trigger the brown fat to fire up, and it starts to burn down the fuel from harmful white fat. All right, this is a process called thermogenesis. I write about this in my book, Eat to Beat Your Diet. It was originally discovered, by the way, in animals that were hibernating. Because think about it, how do these animals that load up in the fall and early winter, they get these big fat cheeks and big pudgy bodies, they then waddle into a cave, how do they stay warm all winter long, right? And they're not eating. Well, they undergo thermogenesis. Their brown fat fires up, gives them heat, and gives them the fuel that they're using in order to be able to survive the winter. All right, so the fuel that your brown fat gets when you have omega-3s comes from the harmful white fat. And so brown fat is the good fat, fights the bad fat, which is the white fat, and omega-3s, which you can find from seafood of all sorts, can turn on that good fat to burn away that harmful fat. They also help to maintain healthy circulation. They assist the lining of your blood vessels, the endothelial cells, to be as healthy as possible so your blood can flow smoothly.
Go fish!
And what can omega-3s do for our stem cells?
They protect the stem cells that are in your body, We all have stem cells that are naturally found in our body, and these stem cells are important for tissue repair, regeneration, so we heal ourselves from the inside out. Omega-3s protect those cells to keep them as viable and vital as possible for regenerative healing.
Go fish.
What else are omega-3s in seafood good for?
Omega-3s also good for gut microbiome. They happen to be very good for gut health, keeping your healthy gut bacteria very happy. And that means it's good for your metabolism as well. The other thing that omega-3s do is help your immune system. So if you tally that list up of all the things that omega-3s do, that tells you why you want to actually eat seafood.
Go fish.
Where can I get omega-3s?
Now, what are the best sources of a marine omega-3 fatty acids? Well, you've probably heard about it, like tuna and salmon and oily fish. And it's true that marine fish are the best sources of omega-3s. Now, if you're a vegan, you can actually get it from plant-based sources as well, like chia seeds. But that's actually not directly omega-3s. That's from a precursor that your body has to metabolize, and you get a lot more omega-3s if you actually eat seafood.
What fish have omega-3s and which should we eat?
Okay, now, you've probably heard people say eat lower on the food chain because the bigger fish have more likely to have heavy metals like mercury in them. And that's true. That's why you need to be careful about eating swordfish and tuna and some of these larger fish. But then people say, oh, eat really low in the food chain, like anchovies and sardines and mackerels. Now, I actually happen to like sardines and mackerel, all right? But not everybody does. And here's the thing. Sardines and mackerel are not the only ways that you can get healthy omega-3s in seafood.
Nope, go fish.
Dr. Lee will now reveal the first non-oily fish which contain omega-3s.
Cod. Cod is a flaky white fish. It's not considered an oily fish at all. It's very mild tasting, and even people who don't like fish generally like cod if they actually have it cooked really, really well. It does not have a fishy flavor at all. Have you ever had cod? Well, if you've ever enjoyed fish and chips, you know that crunchy British snack in a pub, then it's probably made with cod, so you probably had it because that's what's usually used. All right, I'm not telling you to eat fish and chips, but because it's fried. But cod is a source of omega-3s. How much omega-3 does a cod have? Well, it turns out that cod's, the healthy amount of cod to eat is not very large. It's only the size of a deck of playing cards. So if you want to actually have the same amount of omega-3s that's going to be healthy for your metabolism, all you need is to have that playing deck size, a card deck size of cod. Now, how much omega-3 is in there? 284 milligrams. All right, so you might say, I have no idea what those numbers mean. Well, let's compare it to a known oily fish that has omega-3s, like salmon, okay? So salmon, the size of a deck of playing cards, has 1,565 milligrams of omega-3, all right? So that's five times more than what cod has. Cod has only 18% of what salmon has. So the question is, does cod have enough? And the answer is yes. Cod has enough omega-3s in it to give you a health benefit, all right? So that's a big surprise.
Here is a study which explains why cod is a good source of omega-3s.
Now, the other thing that omega-3s do is they help you burn body fat. And this is how cod has been studied to know. So we know that the smaller amount of omega-3s actually makes a difference. So this is a study from the University of Iceland where they studied 324 people and gave them either salmon, oily salmon with a lot of omega-3s, or cod, not oily, and much less, five times less omega-3s, to eat three times a week. That's not very much, for 8 weeks, okay? And what they did at the very end of the study is they measured the amount of weight loss that was there, and they also measured body fat. And here's what they found. The salmon eaters, not surprisingly, lost a good amount of weight. They lost about 15 pounds, okay, after 8 weeks of eating salmon. But the cod eaters also lost weight. They lost about 10 pounds in the same amount of time. 10-pound weight loss, improvement of metabolism, that's not bad. So even though cod has five times less omega-3s than salmon, it has enough to burn body fat and improve your metabolism.
No! Go fish!
The doctor will now share how he likes to prepare his cod.
Now, I love to cook cod, and there's a lot of super easy ways to do it. So here's a practical tip from me to you. Easiest way that I can tell you how to cook cod, get it in your seafood section or a fishmonger. All right, fishmonger is a purveyor that actually only sells seafood. All right, and you take it home, a little piece, you don't need very much, and you can bake or broil it in the oven. Just preheat the oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit, and while the oven is heating up, it's gonna take a few minutes, all you do is you coat the cod with some flour and mix in a little bit of dried oregano, all right? Get a pan, like a cast iron pan, sear it, okay? Add a little bit of extra olive oil and sear it on each side, about 2 minutes on each side. You can add a little garlic if you wanna give a little more flavor. Then put that onto a baking sheet, squeeze some lemon onto it, and then the oven should be hot. Bake it till it's flaky. Just takes about 10 minutes on each side, and just take a fork and you can just check it and you can see it started to flake apart and you'll be done. That is the tastiest way for you to get healthy omega-3s that can light up your metabolism, all right? And there are lots of different ways of using cod in Mediterranean recipes, and you can actually look up more just by searching cod recipe and hit video on Google and take a look at some YouTube videos of other people that actually know how to cook cod in healthy, easy ways. Okay.
Go fish! Fish cake with swirl!
Now, Dr. Lee will reveal the second source of omega-3s we should consider.
Is sea bass. What am I talking about? Sea bass is a fish that contains healthy omega-3 fatty acids. And what omega-3 fatty acids do is they actually help to improve your stem cells. They protect your stem cells. And in diabetes, that high sugar state actually stuns the stem cells in your body. Now, I write about stem cells in my book, Eat to Beat Disease. And I talk all about how diabetes can actually compromise your stem cells. You need those stem cells to regenerate your heart, your blood vessels, all of your organs, and diabetes suppresses it. Eating sea bass with omega-3 fatty acids actually protects those stem cells, which can be really, really important for healing if you've got diabetes. Now, here's the other thing that is more recent research has shown, that sea bass contains peptides. These are little fragments of proteins, okay? And these peptides can actually stimulate wound healing. And wound healing is an issue that every diabetic needs to be aware of, because as their blood vessels are compromised in diabetes, it's really easy to actually have a situation called neuropathy. Neuropathy is where you actually, your nerves don't work properly. So think about what happens in your foot. If you actually step on a piece of glass, a thumbtack, and your nerves are working properly, you're going to pull back, right? You're not going to step on it, and then you're going to look at your foot, and you're going to clean it off and put a Band-Aid on it. Diabetics actually can't feel that injury because their nerves are actually dulled or even dead. And then what happens is that you step on something sharp, you don't feel it, you create a wound. That wound, you don't even know you have it, gets infected, and now you don't have enough blood vessels to be able to heal that area. Diabetic wounds in the foot are a big deal. In fact, they are called chronic wounds because they often don't heal and they keep on getting infected and unhealed. That can lead to an amputation. So, one of the foods that you might want to eat, if you've got diabetes and you want to protect yourself from wounds and you want to protect your stem cells, is to actually have sea bass. How do I like to eat sea bass? Well, there's so many different ways you can eat it. I can tell you, I write recipes in my book, Eat to Beat Disease and Eat to Beat Your Diet. I think that Eat to Beat Your Diet has a recipe for steamed fish. You can put it into a steamer, all right? Just a nice chunk of the fish, steam it up. Then with a little bit of soy sauce, a little bit of sesame oil, slice some ginger up right on top of that. Steam it just for about 10 minutes. It'll be done. And then you can put some soy sauce on top of it, and even some really hot smoking oil, pour it on top of that. Garnish with some chopped, scallions, as well as a little bit more soy sauce. That is a way, in order to be able to create a nice sea bass. You can also pan saute it. You can grill it. Lots of different ways to enjoy sea bass. Just go ahead and Google it and find out sea bass recipe and watch a video showing you, having somebody show you how to actually have this healthy fish to put on your plate if you've got diabetes.
Let's go fishing.
Yes.
Fish, 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 fish.
And now for the third source.
Shrimp. That's right. Shrimp also has healthy omega-3 fatty acids, and they're delicious. Now, you want to get wild-caught shrimp, not farm shrimp, because farm shrimp are often grown, farmed, in areas that are not so sanitary. So look for the wild-caught shrimp. So, I love shrimp. So how much shrimp do you need to eat in order to be able to get the same amount of omega-3s as cod? Guess what? You'd only need to eat 4 medium-sized shrimp, which you can easily find in the seafood section of your grocery store. And if you don't have fresh shrimp, you can get frozen shrimp or previously frozen shrimp in the freezer section. We often have frozen seafood. Now, you can even make shrimp kind of like a side dish and get your omega-3s without it having been the main dish. Now, I like to cook shrimp very, very simply. So I'm going to give you some tips. First, if you want to get the most flavor out of a shrimp, okay, what you want to do is cook the shrimp with the head on. So you have to go look for shrimp that actually is sold with its head on. Go to the Asian grocery store or the Portuguese grocery fish market. You'll find they often sell the head because that's where a ton of flavor is, okay? About 10 times the flavor of the whole shrimp is packed inside the head. So you get everything. When you cook with the head, you get all that flavor oozing through the entire flesh, all right? Second tip is cook the shrimp with the shell on. But the shell also has shrimp flavoring. All right. And by the way, it also has a natural bioactive called astaxanthin, which is what makes shrimp pink when you actually cook it. So the shell and the head gives a lot of flavor to the shrimp while it's cooking. Also keeps it moist. All right. So that's my tip for you and how to actually get the most flavor out of it. Now, if you're using frozen shrimp, now frozen seafood can be just as good as fresh caught. And the reason is when it comes onto the boat, it gets frozen, snap frozen right away. So you're actually catching all that omega-3s and everything else that's just frozen. There's nowhere to actually degrade it, no time. It's locked in, all right? But if you're using frozen shrimp, what you do want to do is you want to actually thaw it, okay? You can thaw it in some water and defrost it first before you actually cook with it. That way you can make sure that you can cook it all the way through, which is actually really important for any kind of seafood. All right, so what are some of my practical tips for you for cooking shrimp? I like to use a cast iron pan. I put a little extra virgin olive oil on it. I add a little bit of garlic, okay, and while that's heating up, you gotta prepare the shrimp. So if the shrimp's got the shell on it, head or not, okay, what I do is I take a knife, a paring knife, and I slice down the back of the shell, okay? If you're not that comfortable with a knife, you can also use a pair of scissors. Cut all down the back. And then you take a blade and you just scrape out the thin vein, okay, down it. And now you kind of cut it into it lengthwise about halfway down. Now when the shrimp cooks, it'll open up just like that beautiful shrimp that you see when you go to our restaurant, all right? And you do that, if you want to peel it, you can peel the shell off. But if you leave the shell on, which is what I recommend you do to get more flavor out of it, then you just sear the shrimp that way. About 3 minutes on each side, you'll see the shrimp open up like this, all right? And it'll actually turn kind of white and solid from transparent, which is what the raw shrimp is, to a whitish color, and just pull it off. Okay, if you want to add a little splash of white wine, a little bit of tomato sauce, crushed chili flakes, if you want to actually put a little zing with chili peppers, now you've actually enhanced it with some capsaicin, which is a bioactive that lights up your metabolism. That'll enhance the brown fat triggering, burning effect of the seafood, the omega-3 fatty acids. So that's another way to get a lot out of it.
Thanks for the tip.
The following three sources of omega-3s should also be considered.
But I bet you didn't know that clams and mussels and oysters, which many, many people love, also have omega-3 fatty acids. So, and again, those omega-3s protect your stem cells and they actually promote healing. And they actually help level off your blood lipids and lower inflammation as well. Again, these are all issues that you want to think about countering if you have diabetes.
Some people might be aware of clams and oysters, but not mussels. Dr. Lee will now describe them.
Next surprising seafood are mussels. This is the kind of shellfish. You probably have seen it. It kind of looks like a clam, but it's oval and it's got a black shell. All right. Now, mussels are very, very popular in the Mediterranean and in Asia as well. But you'll see them steamed. You'll see them cooked with pasta. Paella, as a seafood paella, the Spanish rice dish, will often be loaded with mussels. Lots of different recipes out there. Okay. And you can buy mussels on alive on ice in a mesh bag. And I'll just tell you, they cook really, really fast, just in about 5 or 10 minutes. So it's a great way to actually cook something very, very quickly in a delicious way that's got good, healthy omega-3s. All right. First, let's talk about how much omega-3s that mussels have. All right. Now, to get the same amount of benefit, omega-3s, as a piece of cod, you would only have to eat about 10 to 12 mussels. That's about this big, got a little piece of meat in the middle of it. That's a bowl full of mussels, okay? Perfect for a meal. So in one bowl, 10 or 12 mussels, you'll get exactly the amount of omega-3s from the meat of the mussel that you would actually get from a piece of cod. Now, mussels are a super solid source of omega-3s. In fact, there are even healthy dog foods that contain mussel meat in order to give pets, man's best friend, healthy omega-3s in their diet. So humans don't miss out.
Here's how the doctor likes to cook these three shellfish.
Okay, so what's my favorite way of actually cooking clams or mussels? You know what I do? I actually take a pot, a kettle, or I take a pan, put a little bit of olive oil, if you want to chop up a little bit of garlic, and just put clams right in there, or mussels, and get the oil nice and hot, okay? And then you'll start cooking the clams or the mussels. And as you sort of get the pot super hot or pan, you put a lid on it and just sit back, all right? And the juice inside the clam or the mussel will actually boil and pop open the clam or mussel when it's actually finished cooking and release all those juices. Want to throw a little dash of white wine in there? That's another little delicious trick. And now you've got freshly opened, freshly cooked clams and mussels. Another way of actually getting very, very important marine omega-3 fatty acids.
You're a genius.
And now for the final source of omega-3s that the doctor will talk about.
Squid. Now, you might know squid as calamari. You might see that on a restaurant menu. Popular seafood, both in Asia as well as the Mediterranean. And if you don't know much about squid, let me just tell you, it's kind of a tube-like, the cephalopod is what they call them, it's related to it, like octopus. It's got a tube as the main body, and it's got some tentacles on the end of it, all right? And both parts, both the tube and the tentacles, can be eaten, all right? You can buy fresh squid. More likely, you'll find previously frozen squid or frozen squid. And if you get the whole squid that hasn't been cleaned out yet, okay, you can always ask your fishmonger to help you clean it out. To clean the squid, all right, all you do is you actually pull off the tentacles, and inside the middle of the squid, inside the body, you'll see this little transparent, it's like a piece of plastic. It's a hard part of cartilage that looks like the blade of a small butter knife or a cheese knife. This little part of the squid is called the gladius. All right. And it kind of looks like an old fashioned quill on a feather pen. You know, those medieval pens that the Three Musketeers wrote with, and it's got a little quill on the end of it with ink. In fact, the word calamari comes from the Latin word calamarium, which actually means reed pen, the kind of pen that actually has a quill on the end of it. All right. That's the name. That's where it got its name. So here are different ways that you can actually eat calamari. You can eat it sliced up, to slice the tubes up into rings, right? Or you can eat it with the tentacles. Or you can just eat the tentacles. And the best, or you can eat both together, obviously. Best way that I like to suggest that you try calamari is saute in the pan, all right? Again, cast iron pan, add some extra virgin olive oil, add some chopped garlic, all right? Or if you want to do it Asian style, add some ginger and some scallion in an oil in a wok. All right. And then throw the rings and throw the tentacles in and just let it cook that way. All right. Takes about 8 to 10 minutes to actually cook it. But once it's cooked, you'll see the rings get firm and the tentacles will actually also get firm. And then you can add any kind of sauce. You want to splash it with some white wine. You want to add some tomato sauce. put some oyster sauce, black bean sauce, so many ways you can actually finish that dish. And then you can serve it onto a pasta. You can mix it into pasta. You could actually serve it with rice, brown rice, as a healthy rice. Squid's very versatile and it cooks really, really quickly. Okay. Under 15 minutes, you'll actually get it cooked. So how much squid do you need to eat to get the same amount of healthy omega-3s as a piece of cod? Okay. The answer is just 3 medium squids worth of tentacles. All right. Or the rings of about 10 small squid. All right. So it's actually a good bit of squid. A squid meal will actually give you all that you need in order to be able to get that benefit.
Here are a few delicious stem cell boosting seafood recipes. First, consider a salmon with roasted vegetables dish. For this recipe, you'll need a salmon fillet, asparagus, broccoli, carrots, olive oil, lemon juice, and dill. Start by preheating your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit to 100 degrees Celsius. Drizzle the salmon with olive oil, season with salt and pepper, and roast for 12 to 15 minutes. Roast the vegetables with olive oil, lemon juice, and salt until they're tender. Serve the salmon alongside the roasted vegetables, garnished with fresh dill.
This is good.
Another option is a shrimp stir-fry with brown rice. Gather shrimp, brown rice, broccoli, carrots, bell peppers, soy sauce, rice vinegar, and sesame oil. Cook the brown rice according to the package directions. In a separate pan, stir-fry the shrimp along with broccoli, carrots, and bell peppers. Season with soy sauce, rice vinegar, and sesame oil. Then serve the shrimp and vegetables over the brown rice for a satisfying meal.
Arch, this is good.
For something heartier, try a seafood chowder. This comforting dish requires salmon, cod, shrimp, potatoes, carrots, celery, onion, milk, cream, butter, and your choice of herbs and spices. Begin by sauteing the onion, carrot, and celery. Add the potatoes, fish, and shrimp and simmer until the fish is cooked through. Then stir in the milk, cream, and butter, seasoning with herbs and spices to taste.
This is good.
A lighter option could be a grilled tuna salad. Prepare a tuna steak, mix greens, cherry tomatoes, cucumber, red onion, and lemon vinaigrette. Grill the tuna steak to your preferred level of doneness. In a large bowl, combine the mixed greens, cherry tomatoes, cucumber, and red onion. Top the salad with the grilled tuna and drizzle with lemon vinaigrette.
Oh, this is good.
Finally, there's seafood paella, a flavorful and aromatic dish. For this, you'll need rice, shrimp, mussels, clams, chicken, saffron, vegetables, olive oil, garlic, and paprika. Start by sauteing garlic and paprika in olive oil. Add the rice, vegetables, and seafood, allowing the mixture to simmer until the rice is fully cooked and the seafood is tender. Finish with saffron and let the paella simmer for a few more minutes, infusing it with rich flavor. Each of these recipes not only satisfies the taste buds, but also supports overall health with ingredients that boost stem cell activity.
Let's go fishing!
Yes! Fish, 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 fish!
Next, watch the Dr. William Lee Club playlist for more information on the stem cell diet. Thanks for watching Longevity Deprocessed. Hit like, share, and subscribe to stay updated on evidence-based longevity tips. Share your thoughts in the comments, your journey matters. Remember, small daily habits create big changes. Until next time, keep deprocessing for a healthier, longer future. Let's make this journey together.